went to AJ's room the night he died. And to this day, Jason, I don't know why. I don't know why I did. I mean, maybe I just wanted to look at him and see if I could find the boy that once was my son. I don't know if it was just as benign as that, but it didn't matter anyway when I got to his room. Somebody else was in it. I saw who killed AJ.
Why did you say anything to me before, Monica?
Because I really wanted to avoid it.
Just tell me. Tell me who killed him.
It was Michael. I really didn't know why I went to AJ's room. He had caused so much pain. He'd done so much damage. I'm his mother. I just wanted it to stop. I felt, I don't know, maybe I felt responsible. And anyway, it didn't really matter. I was so upset. I was so distraught when I got there. I really wasn't ready for what I saw.
Dr. Quarterman. Is everything okay?
Yes, everything is just fine. My son is sleeping, and I need to go over some things on his chart. If you would just follow me. I didn't even have time to think. Somebody was coming, and I reacted on impulse. I did it. Anything, just to cover for Michael.
No, thank you. I appreciate that.
I think AJ was already gone. But I'm a doctor, Jason. I should have tried to save
him. Monica. Monica, you saved Michael.
So many laws. If he'd lived, he probably would have gone to prison for maybe the rest of his life. And Michael has so much ahead of him. I couldn't let him get blamed for this. I went to Michael's room later that night, and I just watched him sleeping. He looked so peaceful. And I prayed that he would just wake up and think of this as all a really bad dream. He wouldn't remember killing AJ.
I don't think he remembers. I don't think he knows what he did.
I know in my heart, Jason, that AJ would not want Michael's life ruined by this. I know that. That's why I didn't say anything. Now, Carly's been arrested for AJ's murder, and Michael has been subpoenaed, and everything is going to come out.
No,
if Michael gets on that stand,
no,
he
Michael,
can remember.
Michael is not going to testify. Monica, I can't let it happen. Hey.
Jason. Glad you're here. Michael's feeling a lot better, aren't you, sweetie?
I'm glad to hear that.
We were just talking about Michael's treehouse, and I was going to turn it into a clubhouse for Morgan and Christina.
Could you help?
Sure, I'll do whatever you need.
Listen, would you guys be okay here for a while? I want to go downstairs and tell Sonny that Michael's getting better.
Yeah, we're fine.
He knows that I didn't kill AJ.
I'm glad you're feeling better.
I like being home with everybody here.
That's good. That's what we want. We want you to feel safe.
I wrote you a letter while I was gone.
I know, I found it. Sam and I figured out where AJ was living, and we went to look for you. But AJ had already taken you, and I found your suitcase and a letter. I'm glad that you wrote me. You know, I can answer your question now. Your mom and your dad, did not stop loving you, Michael, and they never will.
He was a big fat liar.
Yes, he was.
You and Mom told me not to believe him, and I did.
Hey, you didn't do anything wrong, buddy. AJ did. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry that he tricked you. I'm sorry that he lied to you. But it's over now. He's gone. You don't ever have to think of him again.
Well, I guess, you know, we don't have to worry about Michael, you know, killing AJ.
Really? You think now you're sure?
Well, I mean, you heard Carly. He's feeling much better. If he had killed AJ, he would be traumatized,
isn't
right?
Isn't it possible that he's suppressing the murder even further?
Why does it sound like you want him to have done it?
So what, you think Carly's right now? That I've been planting things in Michael's head to make her look guilty?
Sonny. I need to speak with you.
Carly was just saying that she could speak with you about
he's
Michael.
Better.
She has this theory Michael killed AJ. Can you just tell her this?
I really need to speak with you alone about
just
this.
Just say it in front of her. It's fine. Tell her that Michael didn't kill AJ.
Sonny.
Tell her. Tell her.
Monica saw Michael in AJ's room. And she saw him kill AJ. For Michael, since it happened.
I should have killed AJ myself when I had a chance, when Michael was a baby. Nobody would have missed him. Nobody would have.
Okay, you guys, it's just important that we stay calm here and we try to look at this thing from a local standpoint.
If Michael was your little boy, how calm would you be?
Michael is 9, and he's been severely traumatized for months. No court in the world is going to find him guilty.
I don't want Michael to testify.
Okay.
I don't want that. I don't want my little boy being ripped apart in front of the whole world.
But under the circumstances, it would be a closed hearing, and the verdict would come back not guilty by reason of diminished capacity.
It's not gonna happen.
Okay.
It's not gonna happen.
Right now, Michael does not remember killing AJ. At this point, I think it's better if he never does.
He can't repress the memory forever, Jason. And if the truth comes out, it could destroy him.
Hey, are you a shrink, Reese? Honestly. Because how do you know what Michael is going to do?
If it's public knowledge that Michael killed AJ, he's going to carry it for the rest of his life.
All right, I understand that you two want to protect Michael. But you have to think long term here, okay? If you let the truth come out now, it will give Michael a chance to heal, and you can be there to support the process.
I just want to see my son.
Protecting Michael, healing Michael, will be a very long and difficult road. But it has to start with the truth. Sooner or later, Michael will remember killing AJ. And he needs treatment to help him deal with it.
Well, you know what? He's got a lot of people who love him. We can help him.
Okay, that attitude is naive at best. It's dangerous at worst. Besides, if Michael doesn't come forward, Carly will end up standing trial for a crime she didn't commit.
Carly would gladly do that for her son.
And what if she's convicted? Why risk that when telling the truth could only benefit Michael?
Because if there is a hearing, AJ's death is going to follow Michael forever. People are going to be watching this kid for the rest of his life. He'll be stared at. He'll be whispered about behind his back. People are going to be afraid of him, and I'm not going to let Michael live that way.
We both want the same thing. What's best for Michael? I know your impulse is to protect him.
Mm-hmm. That's How's Michael doing?
He asked me who killed AJ.
What did you tell him?
I dodged the question. I didn't know what to say.
Well, how about the truth? Michael's life has been ripped out from underneath him. He doesn't know what he did. He doesn't know what's going on. He just knows that he's afraid for his sister and his brother.
If he knows, okay, that he killed AJ, is gonna rip him to shreds.
He'll need therapy, that's a given.
Okay, so we're gonna send Michael to a shrink so she can relive, you know, what happened to him over and over and over again from every angle? I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna do that to my son.
He'll thank you for it, Sonny. Maybe not right now, but when he's older and he realizes what you've done for him.
I want you to go upstairs and let him tell you how happy he is to be home. How sorry he feels that he believed everything that AJ told him. I want you to look at that sweet, smiling little boy and you tell me if you want to hurt him anymore. You know what? There's no point to this. He's already forgotten what has happened. Let's leave it that way. She's the least of our problems right now. We cannot tell Carly that Michael killed AJ because she'll just... Yeah, I'll confess to the murder just to protect Michael. You know that, right?
Yeah. But if Carly goes to trial and Michael has to testify, he could remember that he's the one who killed AJ.
There's got to be another way.